बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलामु अलैकुम। आई एम प्रोफेसर हसन एंड यू आर वॉचिंग माई चैनल प्रोफेसर हसन हमायूं। इट इज़ लेक्चर नंबर 39 ऑफ बेसिक स्टैटिस्टिक्स कोर्स एंड टुडे इन द लेक्चर आई विल डिस्कस विद यू द टॉपिक विच इज़ कंसीडर्ड द मोस्ट डिफ़िकल्ट वन बट दैट इज़ द ईजिएस्ट टॉपिक ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स एंड दैट इज़ एक्सपेरिमेंटल डिज़ाइन। वी विल डिस्कस वट इज़ एक्सपेरिमेंटल डिज़ाइन, वट इज़ ट्रीटमेंट, वट इज़ एक्सपेरिमेंटल यूनिट, वट आर द बेसिक प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ द एक्सपेरिमेंटल डिज़ाइन एंड आई विल डिस्कस CR design, completely randomized design. I will discuss ANOVA table of CR design and then we will discuss 3 important numerical questions and 8 important theoretical questions for every written test of statistics. Before starting today's vital and essential lecture of experimental design, I request everyone subscribe to my channel, like and share my channel and click the bell icon for the notifications of the next important videos. Let's start. What is experimental design? It is a plan to get the effect of the treatment on the experimental unit. First of all, I will tell you what is treatment and what is experimental unit. Treatment, first of all, if we have urea, a fertilizer, DAP and phosphate, these are 3 treatments, urea, DAP, phosphate. We want to check their effect on the plot of land. It is experimental unit. Plots of land. Dear students, treatment is a thing whose effect we are going to check, and experimental unit is a thing on which we will check the effect of the treatment. Now I will give you the example. If we have number of plots of land, then that is experimental unit. And if we have fertilizer, urea, DAP, phosphate, these are three treatments. I will give you one more example. If we have dose A, B, C, and we want to check the effect of 3 different doses on the animals. Now animals are our experimental units. And A, B, C, 3 doses are actually our treatments which we want to apply on the animals. What did you get? Treatments are the things whose effect we are going to check, and experimental unit is a thing on which we will check the effect of the treatments, a very important one. If you want to check the effect of seed type on the plot, on the plot of land, then seed type will be the treatment and plots of land will be the experimental unit. Now I will tell you there are how many principles of the experimental design. There are 3 basic principles of experimental design. First one is randomization. It is the first basic principle of experimental design. It is the process of assigning the treatments urea, DAP, phosphate, medicine A, dose A, dose B, dose C. These are treatments we want to apply. We want to apply the fertilizers on the plots of land. The process of assigning treatments on the experimental units randomly, that is called randomization. Randomization is used to remove bias and the extraneous sources of variation. Then the second basic principle of the experimental design is replication. एक्चुअली द लैंड द प्लॉट्स ऑफ लैंड आर नॉट फिजिकली सेम इन दैट केस वी यूज रेपिटेशन वट वी डू वी परफॉर्म आवर एक्सपेरिमेंट द बेसिक एक्सपेरिमेंट मैनी टाइम्स वेन एवर वी हैव दूनोट हैव द सेम एक्सपेरिमेंटल यूनिट वी यूज रेप्लीकेशन एक्चुअली वट डू वी वॉन्ट टू गेट एक्चुअली वी वॉन्ट टू रिड्यूस एक्सपेरिमेंटल एरर We want to reduce the experimental error and we want to increase the efficiency of the experimental design. That's why we repeat our basic experiment many times. Because what is the reason? The plots are not physically same. That's why we repeat our experiment many times. In that case, it is called replication. When we repeat our experiment, basic experiment many, many times. Now the third one is local control. Why we use randomization and replication? Actually, we want to control the extraneous sources of variation. If it is raining on the plot, it is the extraneous source of variation. All the extraneous source of variation cannot be controlled by randomization and replication. We use local control to control the extraneous sources of variation to reduce the experimental error. That's why local control is used. Now I will discuss CR design with you. CR design. CR design is a process of assigning the treatments on the experimental units completely at random. A very important concept. Now I will discuss its source of variation ANOVA table because we will discuss three important numerical questions. First of all, we have source of variation, its treatment, error, and total. Then we have degree of freedom. Then sum of squares, then mean sum of squares. Treatment degree of freedom is always k minus 1. Please keep in mind a very important concept. If you have four fertilizers, DAP, urea, phosphate, nitrogen, then it is k actually. K is the number of treatments applied on the experimental unit. And k minus 1 is the experimental unit. And k minus 1 is the degree of freedom of the treatment. It means if you have 4 treatments, 4 minus 1. 3 is the degree of freedom for the treatment. And what is for total? It is n minus 1. If there are 20 observations in the whole data, it means 20 minus 1, 19 will be the degree of freedom of the total. And how did you get error? Error degree of freedom. It is always total minus treatment. If I subtract n minus 1 minus k minus 1, n minus 1 minus k plus 1, it will be n minus k. What did you learn? If you apply 3 medicines on the animals, these 3 doses are the treatments which we apply and the animals are the experimental units. If you apply 3 medicines, then it is k. K minus 1, that is the 2 degree of freedom of the treatment. Then we have, if we have total 18 observations in the data, 18 minus 1, 17 is the degree of freedom of the total, and 7 and 18 minus 3, 15 will be the degree of freedom of the error. Then we have sum of squares. It is treatment sum of squares, it is error sum of squares, it is total sum of squares. And how do we get mean sum of squares? It is actually S square B. Mean sum of squares for treatment is called S square B. How did we get treatment sum of squares? Divided by its degree of freedom, k minus 1. These are the basic concepts to solve all the important numerical questions for all the papers of statistics. And how do you get S square E? It is called mean square error, actually S square E, mean square for error, and that will be achieved by error sum of squares divided by its degree of freedom n minus k. And how do we find out the F statistic? F is calculated by S square B over एस स्क्वेयर ई. नाउ यू नो वेरी वेल व्हाट इज एक्सपेरिमेंटल डिज़ाइन, व्हाट इज ट्रीटमेंट, व्हाट इज एक्सपेरिमेंटल यूनिट. नाउ यू नो द बेसिक प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ द एक्सपेरिमेंटल डिज़ाइन, व्हाट इज रैंडमाइजेशन, व्हाट इज रेप्लिकेशन, व्हाट इज लोकल कंट्रोल. एंड आई हैव डिस्कस्ड सी आर डिज़ाइन विद यू एंड दैट इज द अनोवा टेबल विच इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, विच इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट वन इन दैट टॉपिक फॉर सॉल्विंग ऑल द क्वेश्चंस ऑफ दिस इज द बेसिक ऑफ सॉल्विंग ऑल द क्वेश्चंस ऑफ दिस इज द बेसिक ऑफ सॉल्विंग ऑल द क्वेश्चंस ऑफ ऑल द न्यूमेरिकल क्वेश्चंस ऑफ दैट टॉपिक ऑफ एक्सपेरिमेंटल डिज़ाइन. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस क्वेश्चंस. क्वेश्चन नंबर वन इज इन अ कंप्लीटली रैंडमाइज्ड डिज़ाइन फॉर अनोवा द नंबर ऑफ डिग्रीज ऑफ फ्रीडम फॉर न्यूमिरेटर एंड द डिनोमिनेटर आर डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम फॉर न्यूमिरेटर इज 3 एंड डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम फॉर डिनोमिनेटर इज 16. The total number of observations must be equal to. We are to calculate small n. It is our target. And we know the degree of numerator. What did we learn? F is S square B over S square E. It means in the numerator we have treatment. Mean square for treatment. It means that is the degree of freedom for the number of treatments. It is 3. We have learned K minus 1. It is 3. It means K is 4. Four fertilizers, four doses of medicines have been applied on the experimental unit. Now, degree of freedom for the denominator means S square E for error, and we have learned N minus K. We have discussed in the table. It is 16. N is not given. 4 is given. Minus 4 will be added over there, and that will be 20. It means 20 observations is the correct option in the exam, a very important one. Now question number 2, if there are 5 treatments, question number 2, K is equal to 5 with 4 replications, to each of error degree of freedom for CRD will be, we are to calculate error degree of freedom. First of all, I will tell you, 4 replication means actually 5 fours are, there are 20 observations in the data. If n is 20, k is 5, we know for error we have the degree of freedom n minus k. 20 minus 5, 15 will be the error degree of freedom. That will be the correct option in the exam. Now question number 3, the last important numerical question of today's lecture. If the analysis of variance of a completely randomized of variance of a completely randomized design CR, the degree of freedom for the treatment sum of squares is 4, the degree of freedom for treatment is 4. It means k minus 4 is given 4, k will be 5. 5 treatments have been applied on the experimental unit and the mean sum of squares due to error is 2, a very important one. S square e is given, that is 2. While the observed f value for testing significance of treatment difference is 12.5, f is also given 12.5. then which one of the following represents correctly the treatment sum of squares? Dear students, we are to calculate treatment sum of squares and these three informations are given. We know the formula of F. I have discussed with you S square B over S square E. F is given 12.5 is equal to S square B is not given, but S square E is given, that is 2. Multiply 2 with 12.5, that is S square B is 25. Now just recall the ANOVA table. What did I say you? Mean square for treatment is achieved by treatment sum of squares over its degree of freedom, that was k minus 1. What is treatment sum of squares? That is 4. S square B वी आर टू कैलकुलेट एस स्क्वायर बी इट इज 25 इज इक्वल टू एक्स ओवर के माइनस वन. हाउ मेनी ट्रीटमेंट्स हैव बीन अप्लाइड के 4 25 फोर द 100 100 विल बी द करेक्ट ऑप्शन इन द एग्जाम. अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 एन एक्सपेरिमेंट डिजाइन इज ए अ मैप इनकोरेक्ट एन आर्किटेक्ट इनकोरेक्ट सी अ प्लान ऑफ एक्सपेरिमेंट दैट इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 इन एन एक्सपेरिमेंटल रिसर्च द एक्सपेरिमेंट यूनिट इज ए एन एनिमल बी प्लॉट ऑफ लैंड सी ग्रुप ऑफ एनिमल्स डी ऑल ऑफ दीज. यस आई टोल्ड यू एन एनिमल कैन बी द एक्सपेरिमेंटल यूनिट देन लैंड प्लॉट ऑफ लैंड कैन बी एनिमल्स कैन बी इट मीन्स डी इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन इन द एग्जाम. क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 अ लॉन्ग टर्म एक्सपेरिमेंट इज एन एक्सपेरिमेंट कंडक्टेड इन ए वन सीजन बी मोर देन वन सीजन सी मोर देन वन ईयर डी बोथ बी एंड सी. यस डी इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन बोथ बी एंड सी. 7 रिस्पॉन्स वेरिएबल इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज ए इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल इनकोरेक्ट बी ट्रीटमेंट इनकोरेक्ट सी डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल. वी नो रिस्पॉन्स वेरिएबल इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल. क्वेश्चन नंबर 8 अनालिसिस ऑफ एक्सपेरिमेंटल डेटा मीन्स ए एस्टिमेशन ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट इफेक्ट्स बी डिवाइडिंग द टोटल वेरियंस इन टू कंपोनेंट वेरियंसिस सी टेस्टिंग द हाइपोथिसिस अबाउट द पैरामीटर्स इन्वॉल्व इन द एक्सपेरिमेंटल मॉडल. यस दैट इज द करेक्ट वन. क्वेश्चन नंबर 9 वट विल बी द करेक्ट सीक्वेंस ऑफ DOE डिजाइन ऑफ एक्सपेरिमेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड द प्रोसेस सेटिंग. द करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज परफॉर्म एक्सपेरिमेंट दैट इज द फर्स्ट स्टेप परफॉर्म एक्सपेरिमेंट then interpret the results next is prediction you will have to predict prediction the fourth and the last one is model optimize now question number 10 the basic principles of experiment research are a randomization b replication c local control d all of the above we have discussed in the beginning d is the correct option. Question number 11 randomization is an experiment helps to eliminate to remove a systematic influences b dependence among observations c human biases. Dear students, B is the correct option, human bias, a very important one. Assalamu alaikum.